It's time to beat the clock. Sights of Broadway, sights of Broadway, sounds of Broadway all around. And there above shines the name Sylvania, pioneering light, sight, and sound. Finer product, better product, best in quality. Made for you by Sylvania, pioneer for half a century. Beat the clock, brought by Sylvania, beat the clock. To entertain ya, it's time to play Beat the Clock.
Now here is America's number one clock watcher, Bud Collyer.
Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. And welcome once again to Beat the Clock, the show where you can have the time of your life playing against time for big-time prizes. Now, if you'll come over here with me, we'll meet our first contestants for tonight. Hello.
Hello.
Your name is Mr. and Mrs. Henry, what is it?
Wainert.
W-E-J-N-E-R-T. You don't pronounce the J, is that it? Wainert, I see. And you live where, Mr. Wainert?
216 Spring Valley Road in Paramus.
Paramus, New Jersey. That's what do you do there?
Automotive machinist.
You have children?
Yes, sir.
How old?
2 and 8 months.
What, 2-year-old girl or boy?
2-year-old boy and an 8-month-old girl.
A 2-year-old boy and an 8-month-old girl.
Right.
Well, a little girl's kind of little yet, I guess, but I'll tell you what. I'm going to step back here just long enough to pick up one of these Buck Rogers Space Ranger kits that Sylvania is giving out. Suppose you take that along home, put it together for him. He might have a lot of fun playing with it. Would you do that?
Yes, sir.
Okay, well, our congratulations. I want to tell you folks that two things tonight. Number one, our bonus, of course, runs right along. It hasn't gone anywhere yet. Nobody has knocked it over. So it's worth $700 in cash tonight. And whoever happens to be the lucky one who's at our microphones at the time the bell rings, anywhere during the show, they're the ones that try for the bonus tonight. It's strictly the nature of a bonus. Also, as I announced last week, I hope a lot of you folks got a lot of balloons in the house because we're having an all-balloon show tonight. Every single stunt involves a balloon in some way, shape, or form, okay?
Mm-hmm.
All right, now we'll see just what I mean by that. Started off with a balloon stunt on the $100 clock. So this will involve a little work on the part of both of you.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, it's really going to work around. So I'll show you how it's going to work. I'm going to place this down here, and I have a little quick change to do, so watch what's going to happen. Now, first, I'm going to remove my jacket, hang it here, and then I'm going to put on a very fancy jacket. I want you to see this. We went to great lengths to get this one specially tailored just for me. You like that?
Mm.
All right.
Yes.
Okay. It's a little bit of all right. All right. Now, there's a very definite reason for that, to tighten things up here, and I'll show you why. Will you both come over here with me, please? Now, if you'll come on this side of me, Mr. Wainert. Mr. Wainert, you remain on that side. And give them each a balloon, if you will. There. Now, if you'll stand back of me just a little bit, just about there, I'm going to put my hands on my hips like that. When I say go, you are to push that balloon through my arm without breaking it on that side. You do the same thing on that side. Each of you get one balloon through intact, we'll stop the clock and you'll beat the clock. Now, if you break one, we'll stop and replace it with another one. So just keep pushing, boy, because time's going to be ticking away on you. Take a look over your shoulder and mine and see how many seconds you have. 45 seconds to get two balloons through. You ready? Go. There goes one through.
Oh, brother. I'm telling you. I guarantee, don't ever wear a jacket like this after a fool me.
Well, good enough. You did a good job on that one. You got them both through. And that means, of course, that you graduate now from the $100 clock, moving on up to the $200 clock in just a moment. You get all out of breath on that one?
Yes.
Not nearly as much as I did. I was the one who was working against you. Well, right now, I'd like you to meet the kids of the hour, as a matter of fact. They're two of Buck Rogers' proudest space rangers, Jim Wells and Sally Jones.
And here they are, all dressed up with their chronoscopic space compasses, their disintegrator guns that actually shoot flying saucers, and their Buck Rogers space helmets and protective masks, and they're all set for space scouting fun. Yes, dear boys and girls, with this Buck Rogers space equipment, you're all set for 1,000 interplanetary adventures. There are 21 different items in this space kit, including your spaceships here, and your rocket launchers and rockets, a pair of interplanetary phones, and these really work, your Buck Rogers pendants to go around your neck, and badges, and best of all, it's all yours absolutely free. It's your nearest dealer who sells Sylvania television sets. Here's all you need to do. Invite your mother and dad to go with you to your nearest Sylvania television dealers to see Sylvania TV for 53. Believe me, they're going to be thrilled when they see those Sylvania sets with Halo Light, that frame of light for greater viewing comfort. And you'll certainly be tickled when you get your free Buck Rogers Space Ranger kit and a membership card that makes you an official Buck Rogers Space Ranger.
Calling all Space Rangers, invite your mom and dad to your nearest Sylvania dealers. Soon.
You make it soon. You'll have a lot of fun with those kits. All right, now.
Well, say, here's our own Space Ranger right here, you see? Something the kit does not include.
Well, I'll tell you, as I said before, everything is balloons tonight. So again, we're going to try with some more little balloon stunts for the $200 clock. Now, for this one, we won't need your help at all. Mrs. Wager, it's just entirely your husband. So, Mr. Wainwright, will you come over here with me, please? And let's bring out, while we're en route, our next balloon stunt.
Hey.
How about that, huh? Isn't that nice? Whole lot of balloons hanging there, see? Okay, now, if you'll step up there, Betty has a little shower cap for you, and sit down in that chair, if you will, please, Henry. What do they call you, Hank or Henry?
Well, Henry.
You like Henry better, okay. Maybe. Now, if you will, yeah, zip him up a little tighter there, I think. That's the idea. Make him snug as a... But yeah, if you will, please. Slide around. Just keep the hair out of your eyes, you understand? Mm-hmm. Got him off? You never had attention like that before, did you? Look at that. Now, if you'll just kind of... You'll find that that chair is on wheels that you can move very easily. Will you kind of move it over here? Move it right over here close to me. That's it. And there's a reason for that, too. You're supposed to move around. You're supposed to move down the line from this balloon to this balloon to that balloon to that balloon, right on down the line there. And inside each of these balloons is a little ring. There's a ring. It looks very much like this one here. Here's a sample of it, you see? Now, what we want you to do is to get two of those rings on this little stick like that. See? Now, why is the needle in the end of the stick? Well, obviously to break the balloons, that's right. And where do you hold it? In your teeth.
Know.
There you are, just like that. Don't break yet. What you have to do is to move down the line and get one ring on each one of those balloons, and let's take a look and see how many seconds you have. That's right. Now, you just get two rings from any two of those balloons on that stick. We'll stop the clock. You'll beat the clock. I want to tell you something, sir. There's whipped cream in the balloons. Okay. You ready? In 40 seconds, go. You got one. Blue Dot for sure shot. We'll get you all cleaned up. He beat the $200. You know, he had only one comment. You know what it was? He said it tastes good. I tell you, we'll get him all fixed up. Don't worry about it. He'll return to you just as good as new. As a matter of fact, I'll tell you what. Take that ring along with you as a little token of something that he caught and beat the $200 clock with. Now, it's your turn to try, if you will. Step down to that far end of this platform. I'll tell you when to get up on it. In back of this curtain is our famous jackpot clock. You see, the board that has all the words of a famous saying or quotation on it, but they're all out of order. You get them back in order on that board in 20 seconds from the time I say go, so they read the saying or quotation we're after, okay? All right, open the curtain. Step up on the platform. Go. Hold it. Go ahead. Hold it. Stop the clock. She's got one more word down here on the floor. I'll give it to her. She's on the track. Here it is right here. Where does it go? Go ahead. Go. You're right. Yeah. Sing a song of sixpence, a pocket full of rye. 4 and 20 blackbirds baked in the pie. Let's open the pie right now and see what you've won. You took a what?
A guess.
Well, it was a good guess. Take a look over here.
Mr. and Mrs. Wainwright, your prize is Sylvania's exquisite console, the Montclair, with genuine hand-wrought mahogany inlay doors. Large 21-inch movie-clear television with surrounding halo light for the greatest viewing comfort in all television. The Montclair is outstanding in performance and design. Congratulations, Mr. and Mrs. Wainwright. You have just won Sylvania's jackpot prize.
My congratulations. Well, Roxanne, who is our next contestant?
But our next contestant isn't a contestant at all.
What do you mean?
Well, it's the president of Sylvania, Mr. Don Mitchell.
President of Sylvania? Hello, Mr. Mitchell. How are you, sir?
What do we owe the honor of this visit by you, sir?
Well, Bud, tonight is a special night for both Sylvania and Beat the Clock. So we've cooked up a little surprise for you.
For me?
And here it is.
Well, look at that, would you?
Bud, on behalf of all of us at Sylvania, I'd like to present you with this anniversary clock cake commemorating the start of the third year of Sylvania's sponsorship of Beat the Clock. We think you and your pals here are doing a wonderful job. And I can tell you that our distributors know that Beat the Clock is doing a terrific job for them.
Well, thank you, Mr. Mitchell. That's wonderful. A beautiful. Hey, what do we do? Cut this and eat it here, you and I?
You ought to eat half and I ought to eat half.
We'll share it between us. Well, I tell you, that's a great thrill, I'm telling you. Did you carry this over all by yourself?
All by myself.
You didn't bake it, too?
No, my wife baked it.
Well, on behalf of all of us, Mr. Mitchell, Beat the Clock, being the kind of a show that it is, we're awful happy to be representing Sylvania and happy that you feel the way you do about it. And I want to tell you, we've enjoyed every second of it.
But that ought to make it a good time for both of us.
Good enough, Mr. Mitchell. Thanks so much. Thank you. Quite a thrill. I've never had a birthday party quite like that before. I can't remember my own third. Come on out here, will you, please? Roxanne, who are our next contestants?
Bud, I'd like you to meet Mr. and Mrs. Alan Grant from Washington, D.C.
Thank you, Roxanne. Hi, Mr. and Mrs. Grant. Washington, D.C. That's a busy part of the country these days with a political campaign going on, isn't it? What do you do down there, Alan?
I'm an optometrist.
An optometrist. That's you right. Take a little vacation trip.
That's right.
Well, sort of. Alan's going into the Navy tomorrow.
Were you recalled or just your first
time?
How long will you be in? You don't know, huh?
3 years.
You've been married how long?
1 year.
Just a year. Well, I sure hope you get stationed somewhere nearby where you can be near him.
Thank you.
I hope it goes a lot shorter than you think it's going to. I'll tell you what. Washington, D.C., the Postmaster General is down there, so we have a little mailing problem for you. All balloons, don't forget, so this is another balloon stunt. Would you come over here with me, Mrs. Grant? Just you alone.
Thank you very much, Madeline, and thank you, Betty. Now, here, if you'll step on this side of me, Miss Grant, here is a balloon. Here is a country-type rural, you know, RFD mailbox. Now, what we want you to do is mail this balloon, which we consider a letter. However, what I want you to do is to get it in the mailbox like that. See, then the postman come along and get it. Doesn't seem to be anything very tricky about it, except that you can't touch it with your hands or your body or your feet or your mouth or anything else. You've got to do it entirely with this stick. Now, what's so problematic about that? Simply that this balloon is filled with helium, and if you let it go, it gets away from you. So you've got to maneuver it with this stick till you get it over there and slide it in that mailbox, all within a certain number of seconds. Let's take a look and see how many seconds. 55 seconds from the time I say go. Hold it only in one hand. I'll get around this side from you. Get ready to mail a letter. Are you ready? Go. Here's another letter. Here's another letter. Here we are. Another letter. Right. See, then your right hand can work better. You ready? Got it? Go! Take it easy.
Left. You only had 10 seconds left there. I'm telling you, if there had been one more airmail stamp, you wouldn't have made it. Well, good enough. Mrs. Grant, you did fine. You represented the family on the eve of your husband going into the Navy, and that means you graduate now from the $100 clock up to the $200 clock. And what in heaven's name we got by way of balloons now? All balloons tonight, but right now, let's join that mysterious, mystic, and famed fortune teller, Swami Bill Shipley.
Of my Sylvania infrared headlamp, and I see, I see a Sylvania television set in your future.
In plain talk, that means that a Sylvania infrared heat lamp may help you to win a new Sylvania television set, or a Sylvania clock radio, or a Sylvania table radio. And here's how. This Sylvania infrared heat lamp has many, many wonderful uses around the house. For example, it will just bake the stiffness right out of sore muscles when used under doctor's recommendation. It'll even thaw out your frozen water pipes. It'll dry your hair, nail polish, even clothes. But these are just a few ways that this Sylvania infrared heat lamp helps around the house. And Sylvania wants to know many other uses for its heat lamp. And if you come up with the greatest number of new jobs for this heat lamp, you'll win, you might win, a brand new Sylvania television console with halo light. Now, the decision of the judges will, of course, be final. In case of ties, duplicate prizes will be awarded. So you write a letter to Sylvania suggesting just as many new and unusual but actual uses for this heat lamp as you can think of, and send your letter along with your name and address and the side of a sleeve from the heat lamp or the end of a four-pack of Sylvania light bulbs to Sylvania, Box 1250, Grand Central Station, New York, 17, New York. Your entry must be postmarked not later than December 15th. Remember that address. It's Sylvania, Box 1250, Grand Central Station, New York, 17, New York. It may mean that you'll get a new Sylvania television console for just the price of a Sylvania infrared heat lamp.
Mighty worthwhile looking into. All right, Mr. and Mrs. Alan Grant, Washington, D.C. Now, your wife carries you through the bonus. You get to try the bonus. All right, Alan, come on here alongside of me. Stand right here, if you will. And girls, bring out the bonus. Stay right here, Alan, if you will. That's the idea. Okay, have you seen this? Have you watched it? Boy, this is real tricky, you know. Thank you very much, Madeline. Thanks, Betty. Now, to explain for those who haven't seen it, come on over close to me, boy. All you have to do is to pick up that tennis ball in the little saucepan there, and it must wind up resting on the stage with the ball in it. If the ball goes in and rolls out again, that's no good. It's got to get in there and just sit there. You understand? No. Just like this. See the way it is right now? Just got to rest like that. Of course, if you tip the pot over too with it in, that's all right, too. I don't care about that. The only difference in the way you do it and I do it is that I held it by the handle, you hold it by this string. You hold it by that loop, and you can't wrap the string up around your hand, you can't use your feet, you can't use two hands, can't wrap it around. Just hold it by the length of that string. That's the idea, boy. Yeah, you can get a good grip on it, you know. That's the idea. You get it down a little lower if you want to, kind of like, that's it. Okay. Now, you understand what you have to do. Take a look and see how many seconds you have. Can't use any other part of your body in only one hand. Are you ready? 45 seconds. Go! That's worth $700, boy. For 7 weeks, added $100 a week, it's worth $700 in cash, and a check from Sylvania will be mailed to you for $700. What do you wipe the lipstick off, boy? Leave it on there, and I'm going to give you a little souvenir of your victory. You take the pan and the ball right along with you and try it on your friend. Congratulations to you. Hey, now, we can get down from the top there, you know, back to our balloons. That was just a bonus. You still go on to try the $200 clock. So you better take your coat off, boy, because after what you just did, you got more to do. Hang your coat up on that little hook right there, and let's see what you have to do by way of balloons right now. How about that, guys? You see that? Only 10 seconds. Whoop, there it was. Come on, fella. Over here with me. Thank you very much, Madeline. Now, here are two balloons, you see? Back here is the door. It opens, closes, just like any other door. Why is it there? Why have we got these balloons? I'll show you. You have to start pretty well down here. I'll show you about where. Now, what you do when I say go is you toss these balloons up in the air as high as you can. And while they're still up in the air, you run around that door, open the door, run through it, get back out here and catch these two balloons floating around. Got the idea? All right, take a look and see how many seconds you have in the time I say go. You have 40 seconds to catch both balloons before either one of them touches the ground. The door opens from the other side out, this way. You got to go around the back and come through. Got the idea? Okay, turn around, face front this way. This is where you start, right about here. That's the boy. Take the two balloons. Are you ready? Go! Get around! Get around. Oh, no, you didn't make it. You didn't make it. Right in front of this line. Right in front of this line. Try again now. You ready? Right in front of that line. See it right there on the stage? Step in front of it. In front of it. The other side of it. That's the idea. Have the line back. You ready? Catch them before they hit the ground, before either one of them does. You ready? Go! Get it! Come on! Let me give you a little
suggestion. Let me show you a little something. Instead of just throwing them, if you stand in front of this line and if you toss them like that and hit them up, see, they go way up in the air. They'll get up a whole lot further that way, okay? Got the general idea? All right, and begin to move, boy, the minute it starts. Get in front of that line again. Get in front of that line. Okay, you ready? Go. All right, go now. Now, of course, it comes time for your wife to carry on and try. Did you say your mouth was dry?
Sure.
His mouth is dry. Have a drink, boy. Come on. All right. Step back over here now, if you will. Now, Alan, you can't help your wife in this in any way, I'm sorry to say. But, Mrs. Grant, you carry on for the family. That's the way we always do on this show. And when I tell you to, you step up there. But right in back of this curtain is our famous magnetic jackpot board. All the words of a famous saying or quotation all scramble up. Get them back in order. In 20 seconds from the time I say go, we'll stop the clock. You'll beat it. Okay? Open the curtain. Step up on the platform. Go. Four seconds. Three, two, one. Oh, golly, I'm sorry you didn't beat the clock. The clock beats you. What does he care? $700 bonus. Look at here. It happens to be there is no joy in Mudville. Mighty Casey has struck out. That's what it is. There is no joy in Mudville. Mighty Casey has struck out. But you've done all right tonight, folks. Not only have you beaten our bonus dud, which means we've got to dig up a new one for next week. Don't forget to be watching. $700 in cash is what you won, plus beating our $200 clock. So let's see what else you've won.
For your home, an Estate electric range with a built-in grid all for greaseless grilling and Estate's barbecuer, a separate meat oven that cooks whole roasts with radiant charcoal type heat. Congratulations, Mr. and Mrs. Grant. You have just won a Beat the Clock prize worth more than $200.
Our congratulations. My, some excitement, huh?
Wonderful.
I should say so. Who we got now?
But we have Mr. and Mrs. Donald Worrell from Tannersville, Pennsylvania.
Well, thank you very much. You're a truck driver, Mr. Worrell?
That's right.
How come you're not driving trucks tonight?
We've got a weekend off.
Have you? I guess that's kind of rare, isn't it? You've been married how long?
Almost 5 years.
You have children?
Yes, two.
Boy, girl?
Two girls.
Yes. Well, my goodness, wait a minute. I'm going back here a minute and show you one of these little Roxanne dolls, because I want you to take two of them home, one for each of your little girls, okay?
Can we wave to Donna?
Huh?
Can we wave to Donna?
Can you wave to Donna? Where is she?
She's at home, right?
Is she with her sister, too?
Yeah.
Where, which one is Donna, on the right or the left? Huh? Well, you go ahead and wave while I'm putting this doll down here. That's the idea. And we'll have one for each of them, and in the meantime, we're going to see how good you are at more balloons. So if you'll come over here with me, I'll show you what balloon fiendish thought we've dreamed up now. Thank you very much. Now, if you'll get on this side of me, please, Mrs. Worrell. And, Don, that's right, on your side, on that side. These are ice tongs, as you see. You carry ice in them. Now, if you will take a hold of that handle by that side, you take with this hand on this side, and you'll find that they'll open up or pull together like that. However, instead of ice, what you have to carry is balloons. Now, you carry one of these balloons over and get it in that basket without breaking. We'll stop the clock, and you'll beat the clock. But you must carry it between the points of that thing. It won't nest in it. I guarantee you that. Take a look at our clock. See how many seconds you have. 55, okay, are you ready? Go! Oh! Easy. All right. Okay. Oh, my goodness.
Dennis, you know, people are so excited around here. There's somebody over there just doing like this. They like the balloons. They love the balloon stunts. All right, the big round balloons, little balloons, everything else. All right, now, we'll find out what your problem is on the next clock in just a second. But right now, for a rundown on Sylvania's heat lamp contest, here is Bill Shipley.
Thanks, Bud. And friends, the first big prizes in this contest are a 1953 Sylvania television console with halolight surround lighting, a Sylvania clock radio, and a Sylvania table radio. Those are just the first big prizes. And here's all you do to enter and win this profitable Sylvania contest. Send a letter to Sylvania with as many new suggestions for unusual, different, and actual uses for the Sylvania infrared heat lamp as you can possibly think of. Send your name and address and the side from the heat lamp sleeve or the end from a four-pack of Sylvania light bulbs or reasonable facsimile, along with your entry. Now, Sylvania knows that this versatile infrared heat lamp has a multitude of uses. For example, it will bake the stiffness right out of those sore muscles used under a doctor's recommendations. It'll dry nail polish and hair, even clothes. It will even defrost your refrigerator. But Sylvania wants to know how many new uses you can think of. Now, this contest closes as of midnight, December 15th, and this is the last you're going to hear about it until we announce the winners right here on Beat the Clock. The winners will also be notified by mail, and the decision of the judges must, of course, be final. So don't dally. Get your Sylvania infrared heat lamp right away and write a letter to Sylvania suggesting as many new uses for this heat lamp as you can think of. Send your suggestions, your letter, along with your name, address, and the side of the heat lamp sleeve or the end of the outer wrapper of a four-pack of Sylvania light bulbs or reasonable facsimile to Sylvania, Box 1250, Grand Central Station, New York 17, New York. Maybe you'll win one of these big prizes, topped by a 1953 Sylvania television console. So, good luck.
Good luck for me, too. Good luck from all of us, as a matter of fact. Okay, more balloons. So you come over here with me this time, will you, Don? Okay. And if you'll stand right about here, sir. Right about there. That's it. You notice that we have a pile of boxes here. They're cereal boxes, and I want you to pile them up, one on top of the other, until all of them are stacked up together, you see? The whole pile is there. Every one. I think there are eight in all. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. That's the idea. Thank you very much. It's a little warm out here. Let's take a look at our clock, see how many seconds you have in the time I say go. 45 seconds. Now, the only problem involved is this. Take this in your left hand. Hold it like that with that flat side down. Here is a balloon that is filled with helium. See?
Yeah.
You must keep that balloon in the air. That is, it may not touch the ground or touch your body or be held by anything but that little paddle. Just keep it from going up in the air. And you can't trap it against the ground or against anything, you understand? While with the other hand, you are piling those boxes up. You get the idea? Okay. Can you take your coat off? Sure, boy. All the comforts of home here. Go right ahead. Take your coat off. Give your lovely wife over there. Come on back. I'll be waiting for you. Okay, there you are. Are you ready? Take a look at the clock. 45 seconds. Go! Near and yet so far, and our time has all run out. Now, you can practice that at home. You got any helium at home? Oh, well, I'm sure you can get it right out of the atmosphere. It's one of the gases in the air. Can you come back next week? That's more important. Okay, fair enough. You'll be our first contestant at that time. This will be the stunt you'll do. So until next week, we'll just knock that off, and they can let the balloon go up in the air. Go back and join your wife. And ladies and gentlemen, thanks again to Sylvania for that lovely birthday cake. We hope we're with them for a long time. And this is Bud Collyer speaking for Sylvania, hoping that next time may be your time to beat the clock. Good night, everybody.
Production. Producing association of the CBS Television Network. Roxanne John and Larry Aldrich originally.